Hi, let's talk today about using bonuses, incentives, additions. One of the timeless tactics in sales and marketing, and it is universal, is the use of bonuses, additions, incentives. As the now famous line from every TV infomercial says, wait, there's more. But you don't have to be a TV advertiser to use bonuses effectively to grow sales and increase market. In this segment from another three-day program in Japan, and again, I like Japan because it had to be so crystal clear and actionable. We look at how almost any business can use bonuses or incentives to their maximum advantage, irrespective of the market you serve and the way you sell or market. Have fun. Some examples. Years ago, when DVDs first became popular, there was a video DVD club, and when you joined, if you joined and committed to buy a certain number in a certain period of time, they gave you a DVD player free. There's a magazine called Sports Illustrated in the United States. I don't know if it's here, but they've experimented with all kinds of bonuses. One of the bonuses is they give you a radio to take to the games. Another one is they give you a cushion with your favorite team on it that you can take to the games. Another one is they give you a blanket with your favorite team. Another one is they have a swimsuit edition that has nothing to do with sports, but it has a bunch of lovely models in swimsuits that men like to look at. We have a friend in the product business. They sell information products, and they go to other people who do seminars, and they buy bulk tickets that are very valuable, and they give you a free ticket to a seminar if you buy their collection of products. Spike and I were laughing about the English language thing. We said, if I were in Japan right now, and I'm gonna throw this out free, somebody will run with this. I said, you wanna really own the market? We were talking about English speaking, we're not trying to be arrogant, but we said, it would seem like the more English speaking people had, we're talking about China particularly, the better it would be for their career advancement because it's a growing economy. And I said, if I were in China and I wanted to basically own any training market, I would, because people charge $5,000, $6,000, $10,000 to learn English. I don't know what it costs here, but I said, let's say I'm a training company, I'm training anything else, management, IT, whatever. I would go to corporations and say, if you buy this from us, we'll give you a $6,000 course in English free, and you can take it over a year because you don't care how you get the business. But it's the point I'm making is bonuses can transform two things, the appeal and the preemptiveness, meaning you block everybody else because all of a sudden you've got a proposition that is incomparable. Does that make sense? It's exciting, isn't it? And all you do is find out what bonuses work, but there's one caveat or warning. You got to test it because you may love it. I love this concept of free English classes if you take something else, because all of a sudden you take an industry that's spending, you know, $20-30 million promoting their English training and you give it free and you've got a value already established by everybody else and you get to take advantage of it. I love that, but it may not work. You may try it, nobody cares because it doesn't have the same value as a big brand store or brand school. So you got to test everything, but I'm trying to show you that usually the right addition of the right bonus, and it can be tangible, it can be intangible. You could say, hey, you buy our training and we'll give you free IT consulting, even though we're not an IT company for 50 hours. I mean, it's whatever combination turns on and excites the prospective buyer as long as the cost of fulfilling it is affordable. And when it comes to certain bonuses, it gets even more interesting because now that you understand marginal net worth, now that you understand lifetime value, now that you understand break even on the front end, you could go to certain people who could provide bonuses for you and you could persuade them to charge you very little or nothing because you could show them that when the recipient of their bonus that's been packaged with your product is done using it, there's a high likelihood they would go on and start being a cash user.